Hello, my name is Brian Charlson. I'm Director of Technology at the Carroll Center for the Blind. Today I'm going to demonstrate the Messages app on my iPhone 5 using the VoiceOver screen reader. Let me begin by unlocking the phone.
206.
I press the power button, put my finger then on the home button, slide it up slowly.
Slide to unlock.
Till I hear it tell me slide to unlock, and double tap with one finger in the center of the screen.
Messages.
And the first application it mentions is Messages, because it's on the top row, left-hand column. Whenever I say I'm tapping on something, I'm really tapping on the center of the screen, and whatever was last spoken will be the application that's being executed. So I'm double tapping with one finger in the center of the screen.
Messages, messages, edit button.
And the first thing it tells me is what's in the upper left-hand corner of the application, the edit button, used to delete previous messages and do some other cleanup. I'm going to flick from left to right.
Messages, heading.
There's the heading of the application. Again, flicking left to right.
Compose button.
There's a compose button. As I continue to flick to the right, we'll navigate through all of the content on this screen. Flicking left to right.
411, yesterday.
It tells me I got a message from 411, yesterday. 411 is 411, the information line. And the message.
Plus 1, 2, 5, 3, 2, 7, 3, 4, 1, 6, 6. New number 2, 5, 3, 7, 9, 2, -0, 5, 0, 1. Sunday.
And on Sunday, I got a message indicating that this person's phone number had been changed from one series of numbers to a different series of numbers. Flicking right. Those are the only two messages here right now. If I want to open a message, I'll flick left or right to left.
411.
Back
yesterday.
To 411, and I'll double tap on the center of the screen to select that.
411. Messages. Back button.
And now I have a back button in the upper left-hand corner of my screen. I'm flicking left to right.
411. Heading.
That's now the heading, flicking left to right.
Call button.
I can call that number or
FaceTime button.
Do a FaceTime conversation or
add contact button.
Add this as a contact or
attach media button.
Attach media to a message back to this contact.
Text message. Text field.
Here's where I could put that text message.
Send. Dimmed. Button.
And if I had written something or attached something, I could click on this send button. That's all that's on here. The 411 message was not retained. It was spoken at the time that I received that 411 request. I'm going to now place my finger in the upper right-hand corner. Rather, I'm going to put my finger in the upper left-hand corner of the screen and come down slowly past the status bar
messages, back button.
To the messages back button. I'm now going to double tap
messages, edit button.
To the previous screen. This time I'm going to do a little editing of the messages I've received. So I'm going to double tap on the last thing I heard. And again, always double tapping in the center of the screen with one finger. And now I'm going to flick right.
Messages. Heading.
And again.
Delete 411. Yesterday. Switch button. Off.
And it asks if I'd like to delete 411 message. I do, so I'm going to double tap the center of the screen.
Confirm deletion for 411. Yesterday. Button.
And it wants me to confirm that deletion by double tapping in the center of the screen again.
Search. Search field.
I'm going to flick to the right.
Delete plus 1. 2, 5, 3,
another
2, 7,
one that
3,
I want to delete.
4, 1, 6, 6.
Double tap the center of the screen.
Confirm deletion 4 plus
confirm
1.
By double 2, tapping again.
Plus 1, 2. Confirm deletion 4 plus 1. Empty list.
And now it's empty. I'm going to flick left.
Search. Search field.
Again.
Compose button.
Again.
Messages. Heading.
Again. So. At this point, I'm in a position where I've deleted all my incoming messages. I'm going to do an outgoing message. Flick right.
Compose button.
To the compose button, double tap.
2. Text field. New message. Heading.
And it's going to automatically put me in a position where I have to indicate who I want to send this to. My screen now should have on it a keyboard on the bottom third of the screen.
C.
And I place my finger on it. I'm going to move
Space.
Down and to the left.
Dictate.
Till it says numbers.
More letters.
Now my keyboard has changed to a numbers keyboard. I'm placing my finger in the middle of the bottom third of the screen.
Up.
Moving my finger up.
Underscore. from send. 5.
Until I get to a number. I'll dial my own number. We'll go over to 6.
6.
Release.
6.
Put my finger back down.
6.
Move it over
to
1.
Exclamation dollar. 1.
And then take the finger off.
1.
It's only when I take my finger off that a number
4.
Is dialed.
5.
I'm moving
6.
The other direction now.
7. 7.
And I'll continue this number.
7. 7. 7. 7. 7. 4. 5. 5. 3. 2. 2. 5. 5. 3. 4. 4. 1. 1.
Sounded like many more numbers because it only is taking the one it last spoke as I took my finger off the screen. I'm touching my finger in the middle of the top third of the screen and then flicking right.
Message, text field.
And is now asking me for the message. I'm going to double tap to bring the focus to that area. And now a keyboard has appeared at the bottom, but I'm not going to do it that way. I'm going to do it by dictation. I'm putting my finger in the lower left-hand corner.
Dictate.
I happened to land on the dictate button, but I could have
C,
landed on any
S,
buttons near
C,
that corner. I'm going to move
C.
it over to, though, to dictate.
Dictate.
And then I'm doing a split finger tap. This is
select,
where I
dictate.
Keep my finger on the button in question and
more.
Touch the
numbers.
And touch.
Selected. Shift.
I got to get
more numbers. Dictate.
Come on. There, I'm on dictate. I got to stop slipping. And a split finger tap is where you hold down the item spoken, in this case dictate, and touch the screen in a second location. This is a quick dictation message to myself, period. Hopefully, this dictation will go well, period. Double tap the center of the screen.
Thinking, oops, babe. This is a quick dictation message to myself. Hopefully, this dictation will go well. The depths of the screen.
And you heard a little bit of my talking to you after that short message. Now I'm going to again place my finger in the center of the top third of the screen.
iMessage, text field, is editing. This is a quick dictation message to myself. Hopefully this dictation will go well. The depths of the screen.
And it did quite well, except for picking up when I was talking to you. I'm now going to flick to the left.
Attach media button.
To the left.
2, 6, 1, 7, 7, 7, 5, 2, 5, 4, 1.
Just double checking the phone number.
Cancel button.
I could cancel this.
New iMessage heading. Cancel.
What I'm going to do though is I'm flicking
button.
To the right.
iMessage. Send button.
To the send button. Double tap.
Send. Dimmed. Message received. This is a quick dictation message to myself. Hopefully this dictation will go well. The depths of the screen. From.
It was sent,
6, 1,
and it was
7,
also
7, 7, 5,
received
2,
since
5,
I sent
4,
it to
1.
This phone. All by using dictation. A little bit of keyboarding to put in the to field, but using dictation for the body of the message itself. I'm going to end this by pressing the home button once to close the application.
Messages.
Now I'm going to go to, by pressing the home key twice in a row,
app switcher.
To the messages. App switcher. Messages is the currently open application. I'm going to double tap and hold. That is, tap the screen twice, but keep the finger down the second tap.
Editing apps.
It tells me I'm editing apps. I'm going to flick to the right, then to the left.
Dismiss app switcher.
To the right again.
Messages.
And there's messages. I'm now going to double tap. And when I double tap, it's truly going to close the application and not leave it in memory.
App switcher has no items.
I'm now going to flick to the left.
Dismiss app switcher.
And tell it to dismiss the app switcher with a double tap in the center of the screen.
Messages.
And that's a short demonstration of text messaging.